joined now by Adam Poole, who has probably the coolest title that you can have in the game, Combat Director. Where are you taking combat with God of War 3?
Well, I think we're continuing the way that combat has gone in the previous God of War. So we look at everything that we've had in the past, and we take Kratos' brutality as a starting point. Everything has to go back to that core. And we extend that. So we figure out how to make it more brutal, how to make it more visceral, and what other toys can we give to the player to play with. The first examples that we've done is we add a new weapon to the game, which is the Cestus. And with that, the theory behind that Cestus is we looked at the sub-weapons in the previous game. People will play them, but then they'll always go back to the blades. So we want to make sure that the weapons that we put in are going to be as fun as the blades. And it's a hard thing to live up to because the blades are an awesome weapon, chains with blades on the end of them. So we actually use that in our direction. So the Cestus, for example.
And the Cestus, for people who have seen the trailer, is the lion hand?
Gigantic lions with these big metal rings on them. And if you notice, the rings actually slide around. So when he makes contact with an enemy, that ring will slide forward and create a concussive force. And that concussive force will blast any enemies that are around you away. So your strategy when you have the Cestus is, I want to make contact with people. When in comparison to the blades, you can swing the blades and hit five or six enemies at the time. The Cestus are very personal. So they're a lot like, you know, boxing gloves. So, and when you make contact with that guy, you're going to clear out any enemies that are around you. The Cestus are also going to send enemies flying away. So if you're near a cliff ledge, guy's going to go flying off a ledge. Excuse me, if you're near a wall, they're going to go flying into the wall. They'll get hit. Do extra damage against that wall. You can run over there, beat the crap out of them. You know, it's similar to like Tekken. You know, you're going to get more damage and you can get more combo variation because the guys get stunned there against the wall. Kratos can use the world a lot more to his advantage, you know, with those methods. He can also like grab the guy and just run him into the wall, crush his skull against the wall. A lot of these things that we've always wanted to do, we just were figuring out ways to actually execute it in gameplay.
Now, the Cestus, at first glance, sort of reminded me of the Gauntlet in the PSP game, God of War Chains of Olympus. How does it differ?
Well, we definitely saw the Gauntlet as, you know, the Gauntlet got a lot of positive feedback and people were loving it. So that fed us and made us, you know, realize, okay, we're going in an awesome direction with the Cestus. And with the Cestus, we really want the strategy to change when you have them. It's not just, you know, a different weapon with different attacks, and it has a different feel to it. And as I was explaining earlier, like, you want to make contact with those enemies, you want to create the concussive forces, you want your evades are actually going to change. He doesn't just roll with these giant metal Cestus on, he dashes and goes to the side, left or right, more like a boxer, and they're shorter, quicker distances, so it has a very different feel. So with the different strategies for the Cestus in comparison to the blades, as well as the other weapons that are going to go into the game, we want the player to have a different feel every time they're using them. But we still take inspiration from the original blades. And if you look at the Cestus, he can throw them out. The heads of the Cestus go flying. They're still attached to the chains. He can swing them together, clap them together, and create a big concussion in front of them. So he can still swing those around almost like ball and chains, big giant maces. As I said, with the other weapons, we're taking that into account. What's fun about the blades and giving it a different spin, a different feel, so you'll love the new weapon just as much as you love the blades.
You mentioned inspiration, and you also mentioned that you can switch on the fly between the weapons, and that reminded me just ever so slightly in concept of Devil May Cry 4, how you could switch stances, essentially. What inspirations did you draw upon when entering into designing the combat for God of War 3?
Well, all the combat guys are love playing fighting games. So fighting games are sort of our base ground that we can all have our discussions on. And, you know, a lot of that inspiration comes from that. So, for example, in God of War 2, the fleece that Kratos has, that's inspired from the parry system in Street Fighter 3, which is a complex but fun system if you learn how to use it. But for average players, they're not going to really dive into it that much. So we take that and we try to make that accessible. We open up the window to perform that parry. We take that with all the other combat systems. Anything that we put into the game, we make sure to take it to an accessible level so that everybody can feel what it's like to play as Kratos. I think we're inspired by combat games. We're inspired by, you know, other action adventure games. You know, we look at whatever is fun. But we always look back at who Kratos is and what he's supposed to be. So, example, the combat grapple that we put into the game is a natural extension we've always wanted for Kratos. He can throw his chains out. He can launch a guy into the air, throw his chains out, hoist himself up in the air, pull himself towards that enemy, combo him a little bit. If he sees another enemy down on the ground, he can throw those chains back out, latch into that guy, pull himself towards that guy, shoulder ram him. You can basically link your combos now with this aggressive dash move, instead of just rolling out of the way or rolling towards an enemy. You're actually diving right into the middle of battle. So, it always roots itself back at Kratos. So.
And one more move that I wanted to talk about is we've saw Kratos a number of times pick up a minor enemy and go full on like a running back into the pile.
Sure. Moves like that are starting to come from. Well, we have a lot more enemies on screen than we've had in the past. So not only do we need to change the way that the AI works, we want to change the way that the player deals with those situations. We don't want to have tons of guys on screen and you do the same square combo you've been doing. It's not as effective. So the player has to look at it as, what moves do I have in my arsenal are going to work in large enemy situations? And the ram is a good example of that. You can grab a grunt, pick him up, and then just use his body as a battering ram and plow over any other guys that are in the way. So you're taking out 10 or 12 guys instead of just one. That also works for the fire bow, for example. You can grab the fire bow, shoot one guy, he catches on fire, he's going to freak out, run around, bump into his buddies, the fire's going to propagate, and 10 or 12 guys are going to be on fire. So you can kind of look at that as like, okay, those guys are handled right now, they're all on fire, I'm going to deal with these other 10 or 12 guys. And you can start using more strategies with a lot of these attacks. And that also works on the AI side as well. So you look at the grunts and you're fighting them and they're just doing their normal attacks and they're kind of dumb. They're your play toy, your way for learning how to use the combat system. But if you bring the centaur into that, they almost like have it's like bringing the brain into the group. And the centaur, you know, commands them to all go after Kratos right now. And they all go at the same time and they dogpile on top of Kratos. And you get that Agent Smith moment where they're all on top of Neo and he bursts them all away. So now the player has to deal with, okay, the grunts do have a little bit of a brain. They're a lot tougher now. I need to go after the centaur. I need to change my strategies and kill that brain off so they go back down a level and they get a little dumber.
Tell me, how fun is your job?
It's a lot of fun. I mean, I grew up playing fighting games all the time, and most of the combat designers I work with, as well as the animators, love playing fighting games. They love making things feel good to play. And it's completely on, everything in the game is hand animated, and our animators are amazing. They all do their key animations, and everything that goes into the game, they put a lot of love and care in making sure that it feels like Kratos. So it's not just a guy in a mocap suit that, you know, it changes all the time and it has a different feel to it. It's tons of fun. Yeah.